We have seen our fair share of snow this winter, so it's only natural to be anticipating spring. Flowers in bloom, baseball season, and yes, even spring cleaning. March is a great time to spruce up your home, and Rhode Island Monthly magazine will help you do just that. We visited a local artist who shed some light on her work.
Take a look inside the March issue of Rhode Island Monthly and get inspired.
Rhode Island is such a gorgeous place, and when it's winter time and everything's covered in snow, I mean, you know, then you see all these different colors come up, and just really the nature as well.
Wayne Bishop Designs creates works of art found in many homes.
We are a ceramics company, and we do lighting and furniture pieces, and we sell to the trade, mostly to designers and architects, and basically contract work. I use a lot of references from the past, and then I try to give them sort of a modern feel to them.
Felicia and her team took us step by step through the process.
It starts off with a clay that's like liquid. It's called slip, and we pour that into molds.
Oh my gosh, look at that!
About 30 minutes to an hour later, it's flipped and sits overnight, allowing the mold to absorb some of the moisture and the clay to stick to the sides.
We open up the molds, and then we'll have our piece.
When the edges are smooth, it's time to bake.
We have to fire it once in these kilns, which are sort of like big ovens.
They will look like this. And while white is nice, most come in color.
We do everything from traditional to more contemporary, and I think our real specialty is the color range that we offer.
Customers can select from Felicia's palette, and if the exact hue can't be found, she'll create it.
We do a lot of work for hotels and for high-end residential and contract work, and you know, people will have something in mind, and we normally, you know, we can do almost everything.
Once a glaze has been chosen, it's applied here.
Then after that's done and dried, we'll put it back into the kiln, fire it again, and that's when it'll shrink even more and the glaze will become actually vitrified to the ceramic, which means that it'll become part of the ceramic.
A base is added along with wiring to complete the piece that is sure to brighten any home.
And joining us this morning to talk about this month's issue of Rhode Island Monthly is Associate Editor Jamie Coelho. Good morning.
Hello.
Welcome back.
Thank you. It's been a while.
Yes, it has. Well, we're talking about how we just can't wait to get into spring, mm-hmm. even spring cleaning, mm-hmm. sprucing up our homes, mm-hmm. and you actually featured some homes in this magazine.
Yeah, usually in the issue of Rhode Island Monthly, we have one home feature, but this entire issue is dedicated to it. So you get a sneak peek inside three beautiful homes all over the state, mm-hmm. and then there's another feature with 19 local artists and designers, and there are mini profiles on each one, so you can learn about glass blowers, woodworkers, and metalsmiths all over the state.
And I'm sure then you can incorporate pieces like that, which we just saw some of Felicia's pieces, mm-hmm. and kind of revamp your own home.
Right, and everybody, you know, goes shopping at IKEA and things like that, but these artists, they create family heirlooms that mm-hmm. can be handed down from generation to generation. Things like tables repurposed from wood, and some glass lamps made by a glass blower. So wow. I want to pick up something to yeah. hand down to my son someday.
And they're very unique too, mm-hmm. that's for sure. All right, but before we start adding things to our home, mm-hmm. I'm sure there's many yeah. of us out there that say, there's so much junk in the mm-hmm. house and I got to get rid of it.
Right, and our columnist, Ellen Lieberman, she actually takes a different stance in this issue. She tells about a bad habit that she inherited from her dad, which, you know, my dad has a little bit of this too. It's just not being able to get rid of junk and throw things out. So mm-hmm. she details how she had to clean out his garage after he passed, and then also how her own garage was beginning to be the same type of problem. So yeah. she gives our readers 12 different ways you can get rid of junk.
12, wow.
Yeah, and that's some of them are donating to local organizations, so you get mm-hmm. a nice tax write-off and a feel-good type of feeling for that. And also you can make a little money on the side with some other options yeah. by getting rid of some metal scraps or donating an appliance or consigning some clothing that is just taking up space in your closet.
All great ideas. I can't yeah. wait to read more. As they say, one man's junk is another man's treasure,
right?
Right? Mm-hmm. Before we let you go, though, we should mention that there is so much more mm-hmm. happening in this issue. It's not just homes.
Right. There's a food review involving Rasa in East Greenwich, which if you've ever been to Rosoy or kebab and curry, you know that type of food, mm-hmm. Indian cuisine. It's my favorite, and people should really check it out.
Also to improv lessons.
Those yes, we highlighted some improv lessons. So people, well, I should probably take a cue from that. You can go and learn how to be confident speaking in front of groups by taking an improv class, or you can just go to a local Firehouse Theater in Newport and learn what they do there and go for a show and have some fun.
Nice. You don't need any lessons. She's nailed it. Thank you so much. Yeah. If you want to learn more about any of these stories, just pick up your copy of the March issue of Rhode Island Monthly, available now.